Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeeves here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge, pulling back the layers and dissecting your favorite suggested tracks. Another first time here for the channel, and I feel that after 500 plus videos, I'm maybe cracking the ceiling a little bit about bands I haven't heard about, but no, plenty bands out there I've not done on the channel, even bands that have had incredible success, but that's what this channel's about, right? You're saying, dude, listen to this. And this would be Rise Against, first time on the channel. And looks like formed in Chicago in 1999. And they're considered a melodic hardcore and punk rock and hard rock or hardcore punk. So I look forward to checking them out. I want to, like usual, thank you so much for your suggestions. Like usual, thank you so much for your support. Cups of coffee. People are still buying cups of coffee. Thank you so much. Because you know, when you see the ads, they make the money, I don't. And now I'm getting ready to get out on the road and do some stuff for the kids and forget buying me a cup of coffee. How about a gallon of gas? What? Really? Anyhow, so let's do this. This is Rise Against. The name of the song is Dancing for Rain, and this is off the album Siren Song of the Counter Culture. All right, Rise Against. All right. Stop, right? Sounds like it's gonna go into a real slick section. All right, first of all, I just want to say it's such a fucking joy just to listen to a recording that is as raw and organic and powerful as the guys are in a room and killing it in the studio. I know that might sound like really kind of duh, dude, but the thing is that I've listened to so much music on this channel and so much of it is so good. Even the songs that are being released right now, super progressive, but in the sounds and the recording and the hybrid use of synths or loops or stuff sometimes, maybe I've had my handful of listening to that. Then when I listen to a band where you just know these guys plugged it in and just nailed it, it just feels great. The engineering is fantastic. The drum sounds on this is insane. So is the bass sound. Now, the opening was super cool, but I kind of knew based on when I read the genre was what I'd be expecting. So it would be a nice little way to kind of like, you know, use a shoehorn to get you into the song to just lightly get you kind of in there with that acoustic line. But once they powered up and they do this double time full punk vibe, what I loved is that it had more of a metal type of guitar engineering, if you would. It was really super tight. And it didn't sound overly compressed, but it had a really nice space in it because hard left, hard right, and it sounded like it was doubled. And here's what I love. First of all, the guy's voice is insane. What a great voice. His passion and his power just cuts through in his tone and everything. But I love what the drummer did in, and the bass. So they come in on this double time. Vocals come in, and they keep that energy going without the drummer staying locked in on that. But he's hitting the snare on the one, but then the rest of it is still filling the toms and keeping the energy moving forward with a really sick percussive arrangement on the drums. You know, and that really stood out for me. And that bass playing and the bass tone through it. And the, you know, the bass player was sticking with that kind of double time arrangement as the performance was kicking. That really kept that energy going. And then they cut, and then they go into that cut time. And that was nice and full and fat. And then they get into the hook. And here's another thing that I love. What are we? We're almost 2 minutes into this and I've heard the hook twice. So this is really great songwriting too. I mean, this is really getting to the point. Powerful, and that's the one thing I've learned about punk. I have a very, very small knowledge of punk and stuff like that, but punk songs are not long songs in general. That, from my little experience, they hit you in the face, give you the people's elbow, crush you, get in, get out, get into the next song, you know. And that's what I love about this. They've already hit me twice with the hook, and it's really da 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 da, like that. It's not the notes, I don't think, identical, but it has already made an impression on me that I can kind of remember what that's about. That's great songwriting right there. Fuck, sorry. Oh, I cursed. All right, let me, that was so gaff. All right, let me go back a little bit. Whoa, not no. Endings like that, you know, that's like, that's pulling the needle out for me. And you know, a couple things I want to say briefly about before I just bail on this video. I loved when we went back into that acoustic middle section there. The very first acoustic that was played was actually a single guitar that was right up the middle, that's mono, but maybe with a little bit of room to it. This time, as they doubled that on the second time around, and it sounded so rich and full. It wasn't, it didn't sound like it was a hard left and right pan of a double guitar, and it was so cleanly and so well and precision played that at first I thought, did they use some kind of, did they forge a doubler, you know, because there weren't, like in the early 2000s, there were the embryonic beginnings of that plugin called the doubler, and it really sucked. Plus, a band like this would never, as far as I'm concerned, doesn't seem like they would go into, you know, digital tweaking to get that sound when they can just play it twice. The only reason why it feels like and it sounds like they, it was played twice is there's a couple times where there's some string noises, like some buzz, that you go, oh, okay. So, this, you know, but I really had to listen really hard going, man, this guy is playing like precision, you know, doubling that. Sounded great. And then out of nowhere, they get this cello in there, which I thought was an incredibly cool nuance to bring you down. It's like you cut through the song and they hit you a couple times with that hook and they bring you to this level where you're just like kind of like at that place where you're like, you're in a glide. And then you go through that, you know, that section they took you through. And then they went into standard time. So I think if I'm wrong, I'm sure if I am, you guys straighten me out. But it's as if the song opened up with a power double time and then went into halftime, and then they stayed through that, went back up into it, and then halftime. But then this time they went into the standard time. I love the sound of the guy's voice. Like I said, is absolutely incredible. And actually, that second section after that, the power they came in with, it sounded like that was their bridge. Really, could have rivaled to me anything that I've heard in the current state of, let's say, metalcore-ish type of composition, but engineering and stuff. So, and to hear this was back, what year was this released? 2004, you know, compared to my little window of knowledge with rock and metal during my journey in this year, there was stuff I was going, geez, this sounds that's as bold and ball-crushing as stuff that's been released like 5 years ago. So be it the band was ahead of the curve or whatever the case is, nonetheless, it was super cool. And then finally, the last thing I want to say is the secondary hook in their melody by the guitar player. So he's singing this really super well constructed hook, you know, or the chorus, most people. But there is in the first half of the hook a melody that the guitar is playing that adds as a secondary hook to it. And I can't repeat it in, I don't have that kind of memory exactly what it is. But I thought that was really cool. That is like offered up just a double dose of the hook. You have the principal, and then you have this other melody the guitar player played. I think it was a little bit on this side, which I dug into. Because, you know, remember, I don't listen to lyrics. I'm not trying to listen to lyrics. And, you know, if I'm going to glam on the vocalist, it's because of the performance. And also, there was that scream that he did. That was like, you know, like I said, I'm looking at this in 2004, which is only what? It's only. And now it's like 18 years ago. And yet, the vocals and the power of what it is that's about seems to still be the line to hit by vocalists today in new bands is to achieve, you know, a sound like that or that style. Anyhow, I went on longer than I did, like I always do. Most of you bail anyhow right after the end of the song. That's why I say if you're still here, type in a comment. I'm still here. And if there's any other Rise Against you'd like for me to check out, please put that in there. And once again, I finally, a cup of coffee or a gallon of gas, whatever. If you want to support me in the channel, the links will be down below. The link will also be down below, for Rise Against. All right, guys, take care. Have a killer day. All right.